Throughout the trip, we got to see some pretty cool lizard species. This, for example, is a greater earless lizard. These guys were so common. They were always hanging out and basking in rocks and on cacti. Really cool animal. These guys were pretty feisty. We saw two males having a standoff on the road. Really cool. Probably the most common lizard species that we saw in Arizona was the tiger whiptail. These guys were always on the ground looking for insects and bugs. They were really twitchy too. It was just an awesome animal to see. We also saw a lot of desert spiny lizards. They really look like the fence lizards that we have back in New Jersey. But the fun really didn't start until the nighttime. Whoa, pull over. I think I see something. Hey guys, we found a Sonoran Sidewinder. Just a beautiful animal. Wow, check this out. This is Crotalus cerastes. It's a small species of rattlesnake, but what's really cool about them is their sidewinding motion that gives them the name the Sidewinder. Now, since the soil in the Sonoran Desert is very loose, the sidewinding motion that these guys use actually gives them traction on the loose soil, which makes it easier for them to move around.
Let him go.
Eat. Beautiful animals. You got perfect camouflage, like that granular sand and those keeled scales that make it blend in perfectly with the sand. We were so happy to actually get to see such a unique animal. I mean, check out those horns and that small buzzing tail. It's really just a beautiful animal, that patterning on their backs. But what really gets to me is those horns. That's just unbelievable. Truly an awesome snake to see.
Okay, let's go. Okay, let me move him off the road.
It was a real pleasure working with such a unique animal. Cowboy boots, I like your best in my cheap suit. Whoa, I cut the brakes to your racing heart, 'cause you're a real fast girl. Hey guys, well, we're walking in the desert surrounded by mountain lions, killer bees, rattlesnakes. Pretty much anything that's dangerous here. This is a little toad. It looks like a red spotted toad. I could see it by the specks all over his back. It's a cool little toad. Awesome animal. They're so adapted to the desert. It's unbelievable. They got the venom sacs on their on the back of their necks too, just like all the other toads. Pretty cool. So I'm hopping along the road. Nice animal. Now the very last snake that we saw on the trip was a coachwit. We attempted to catch this animal, but all we got was a single decent picture. Hey guys, thanks for watching the Herping Experience Arizona special. I'd like to say thanks to a few people. For one, I'd like to say thanks to the Arizona Herpetological Association. You guys really helped me out by sharing all this information from so many different people, and I just wanted to say thanks a lot. Also, I'd like to say thanks to Wayward Muse and Smet Logic. You guys just shared so much great information with me, and I'm sure that if you didn't share that, I wouldn't see any of the stuff that I did. And I'm so grateful for everything that you've done for me by keeping my hopes up and just sharing all this wonderful information with me and actually making this one of the most productive herping trips I've ever had in my life. So I just like to say thanks again. I'll post Smet Logic's link right here and Wayward Muse's link right here and all the other links for, say, the Herp Center and the Arizona Herbological Center. You guys really helped me out, so I'll put the link down there. Again, thanks for watching, and... Oh, hey, look. It's a black rat snake. I'm just gonna go catch this guy, so I'll see you later. Thanks for watching the Herping Experience.